Wishing you a very, very happy Diwali, let's learn how to make a very simple Mysore Pak. Namaste, Salam Walekum, Sasriya Kal. Welcome back to another session with your Vahchef at wareva.com. We're going to revisit some of our old recipes as I promised. So we're going to make Mysore Pak. You know, Mysore Pak is one of my favorite, and especially when it is made with ghee, it is just outstanding. And the softer the Mysore Pak, the amount of sugar you reduce. But a lot of people, to make it nice, bubbly, big, you need to add the right amount of sugar. So adjust the sugar in such a way that you like it. So I'm going to give a recipe where you're going to use 350 grams of sugar for 125 grams of besan. So the recipe is here. Don't again ask me to give the recipe. So first, we're going to heat the ghee, or you can use any of the vegetable shortenings or even with oil. Here, just we want to make sure that this ghee or the shortening, whatever you use, is nice and piping hot, because when we add it along with the mixture, what we're going to do it now, you know, it has to kind of give bubbles and the fumes. So I'm going to let this melt and become hot on another stove. Here I'm going to, whatever little leftover ghee or whatever, you just take a mold and just apply a little bit on the sides, so that when we pour it in this, this will come out easily. This is also ready, and we're going to keep it on the side. You know, if you love Indian sweets, you know what I would suggest is go and buy a nice iron kadai which is thick bottom, because I intend to make a lot of Indian sweets. I am using a kadai like this. So for this, first we're going to make a sugar syrup. For making a good Mysore Pak, we need to bring the sugar syrup to a consistency of little bit you know, string kind of consistency. So first, you know, do not add too much water. Add just if you are taking 1 cup of sugar, half a cup of water should be good enough. In fact, this is also way little too much, but anyway, I'm going to cook this to a consistency where it comes to one string consistency, you know, slightly thicker than the gulab jamun mixture, in which we're going to add the besan flour. Besan flour is the chickpea flour, what you can buy in the market anywhere in the Indian stores. A lot of people find it difficult, but a little bit of technique needs to be used, and everything is in the sugar consistency. You know, once you have the sugar consistency perfect and the hot oil or the ghee being poured on top, you're going to watch it. Watch carefully. If you trying to attempt this sweet, at least watch this video 4 or 5 times, because I'm going to give you small tips. Slowly bring this sugar syrup to a nice boil and to the consistency of one string consistency. We're going to bring this to a single string consistency. So what is single string consistency is, when this cools down, you know, this is cooling down, you will see the nice string being formed. Look at it, the strings being formed. When this consistency come, I kind of switched off the stove, so that to show you, we're going to take the besan, we're going to add in this, all of this at a time. You know, mixing with this will be a little difficult. I'm using the whisk. You can also use simple like this, without any lumps. We're going to first mix this well into this, and then we're going to cook this. Do not worry, just mix all of this and make this into a, like a paste. Look at this, nice paste. You do not want any of the lumps. So once you have the consistency, then you can do it like this. Now we're going to cook this till this fumes, this get kind of furious, and that's when we're going to have our awesome Mysore Pak ready. On the other side, I have the sizzling hot ghee, the oil ready. We're going to pour little by little into this. Once you have this, you remember how we made the kova? You keep mixing without stopping. In between, I'll not open my mouth because I have to watch this carefully. And another thing is, we added the besan raw. So what will happen is, in this sugar, when it reaches this 165 degree centigrade, the caramelization point, and putting that hot ghee, that will cook this besan very well. When you start seeing these bubbles being formed in the center, now we're going to add hot oil. Look at this. This is nice ghee, and keep mixing. Once this entire ghee is absorbed, just add some more and keep mixing. You have to be very, very careful. So don't let it even burn a little bit. Like this, keep adding this mixture, ghee into this, and without stopping even for a second. Otherwise, it will start burning. Keep cooking. Once you see these bubbles and this becomes slightly, pour this hot ghee into this and just keep mixing. You will see these bubbles forming. This is what will give nice holes to it. Be very careful. In fact, if you can take somebody's help pouring that ghee, it's even more better. Again, this is all mixed up, and now again, hot ghee into this and keep mixing and adjust the flame. Once the entire thing is absorbed, then you will see these bubbles, and then we're going to put it in the pan. Now, you know, once you see that this is all nice and these bubbles are forming, you can see slightly this may get color. This is all perfect. So, switch off the flame and we're going to transfer this hot, you know, this bubbly mixture into this mold. Just careful. Look at how the ghee is all coming out, but this has to set. You can practice couple of times. In case the mixture, you know, the moisture is out too much, then as I added a little bit of milk, so that dilutes it, and then again keep oiling and mix it well. So the thing is, the entire ghee or the oil will be absorbed by it. That is why these Mysore Paks are very rich. So once this is all done, we're going to let it set for like, you know, first 10 minutes and then cut it. You have to cut it when it is still, you know, little bit hot. Otherwise, you will not be able to get a nice cut. Once this is slightly set for a few minutes, I'm going to cut it and cool it, and then I'm going to unmold it. Now, see, look at this. The entire ghee is all absorbed. So now in this, just, you know, the sizes you want. So this is good. It is still holding the shape, but be very careful. Because I made a really nice Mysore Pak, once this is cold, it'll set very, very good. So cut them into pieces the sizes you desire, and later we're going to unmold it and we're going to see how it is come out. Dear friends, you know, while cooking, it was very difficult to talk, but once the mixture, you know, is absorbing the ghee and all that, if you at any point of time you feel that it is getting a little bit tougher and you don't have enough bubbles, it is going to be hard, then you can add a little bit of water, or you can add a little bit of milk like the way I did. So that is only to, again, you know, because you do not want really rock hard Mysore Pak, to make it lighter. So the moisture content has to be at one point so that the Mysore Pak sets well. If it is go below to a point, then it becomes very hard. If it is above that, then it will become very soft. There's a right way to do it. Once you set it, whatever little bit ghee will also be absorbed by it, and then cut it the way I've shown. Then we're going to unmold and we're going to see how it is come out. So dear friends, it is very easy to make. Of course, there is a little bit of skill required, and if you can get another two hands to help you while making it, it's even more better. I'm going to show you even the dark centered Mysore Pak, which is going to be a little bit hard. This is nice, beautiful golden color and perfect. In a lot of sweet shops, you will find really dark yellow color. They add a little color to it to make it bright yellow. So these are perfect. And always, you know, whenever I see Mysore Pak, Mysore Pak is one of my favorite sweets. But it also reminds me of, you know, young boy days. Whenever they used to make Mysore Pak at home, one or two things always go into my pocket. During the day, it would have been good. But when I sleep in the night in the same shorts, you know, I used to have ants coming, and some of the scariest things happened. So be careful. Do not put these Mysore Paks in your pocket. And very perfect and light, and they will literally melt in your mouth with every bite. Inside will be a little bit darker color. That is because of the heat. The bottom layer and top layer will be lighter, and the center part will be a little bit dark brown. So very nice, perfect, and literally melting in your mouth. So dear friends, follow the recipe, and you may fail the first time, second time, but you will get it. Once you get it, you will become the fans of Mysore Pak. Not only that, you will become the sweet hero in your community. Make it and eat it, and always keep saying, Vareva.